So you want to make video games? Well, it's a hard life. In this video, we have some talks that will set you off on your journey with the right foot forward. We'll be looking at 5 great GDC talks that are around 30 minutes. And 30 minutes might not seem short, but for a GDC talk, it definitely is. And you'll easily make that time back from the things that you learn in these talks. My name is Giggity McDee, and if you like game design, or if you want to learn how to make games, this is the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button. All the links to these talks will be down in the description for you to check out. GDC is probably the best place on the internet for long-form game design content. For those who don't know what GDC is, the Game Developers Conference, abbreviated to GDC, is a conference held every year that is developer-focused. There are lots of consumer-focused conferences like PAX, but GDC focuses on developers coming together to share their wisdom and network with one another as professionals. The conference runs over several days, and presentations are held throughout, and some of these talks make their way onto the GDC YouTube channel, which means we have the opportunity to extract the wisdom of the best in the business. It can be a bit of a task to wade through them all, so I am going to suggest 5 talks that I think are extremely valuable to anyone making games. The first talk is called Game Feel: Why Your Death Animation Sucks. This is a great talk that attacks the idea, just because you have a game that has functional mechanics doesn't mean it feels good to play. The presenter.
Hi, I'm Nicolae Berbecem. I'm an indie game developer from Romania.
Goes through things that you can add to your mechanically functional game to make it feel and play much better. Covering things such as animation, screen shake, and the lesser known chromatic aberration, it's a great talk to cover many of the basics of game feel. There's a bit of fun in there too, as he demos the game with people from the audience, and he does a great job of explaining each technique. This is a great place to start. The second talk is called Get Journalists to Cover Your Game: Lessons from Online Dating, Praying, and No Man's Sky. Having a game that runs is only a small part of being a successful independent developer. There are many other parts of the game development process that sit outside of building the game, and marketing is one of them. There are quite a few very useful PR and marketing talks on the free GDC channel. I picked this one because it's a compact, shorter talk that covers many different techniques quickly, so you can get a lot from it. Then you can follow up on anything else you thought might be interesting. In the talk, Thomas Reisenegger gives us some useful stats to think of about the space we are entering when we want to market our indie game. Then he gives us some tips on how we can approach marketing our game to various parties to get maximum cut through and hopefully get our games featured on news sites. Just a side note, stats are great for framing, but can sometimes go out of date really quickly, so just be careful when you see stats presented, particularly around things like VR. Next up is Storytelling Tools to Boost Your Indie Game's Narrative and Gameplay. And this entry in the list is kind of 2 talks. Look at that value. Matter Haggis is the lad giving this talk, and I say this entry is kind of 2 because Matter has 2 talks and they are both great in their own ways. This one is a crash course for storytelling in games and gives the audience a structure for how the story in the game should play out. He covers flow and its effect on the story, dramatic moments, and how to craft the kind of tension you need and more. There are lots of examples, and Matter loves these box diagram things which will eventually get filled up with all the key points from the talk, so you have a useful takeaway. If you are new to narrative, or looking at adding narrative to your game, this is a good talk that covers many of the considerations specific to writing for games. The second talk from Matter is called Writing Nothing: Storytelling with Unsaid Words and Unreliable Narrators. And this is for the more experienced narrative designers out there that are looking for new tools to up their writing game. In this talk, Matter covers ways that you can write the same amount or less and convey deeper meaning with your writing. He uses plenty of examples in this talk too, so you really grasp the concepts he is talking about. And there's another takeaway graphic at the end. Things covered include using non sequiturs, leveraging an unreliable narrator to change things up for the player, and also making omissions that the player needs to fill in that deepen the understanding of the character's mindset. Both talks are 100% worth looking into. The fourth talk goes by the title Design in Detail: Controlling Landsliders. This is just a great down-in-the-dirt talk about one part of a game's design. It's a great example of why you need to listen to your audience and also how to work through a design problem. In the talk,
my name's Luke Muscat. I am the creative director at Pretty Great. I was previously the chief creative officer at Half Brick Studios.
Talks about how they implemented controls in their game, Landsliders. He goes over some of the problems that they had and walks through how they went about solving them, such as whether they should include inverted controls, although it clashed with their vision. There are a couple of neat tips and tricks and cool solutions, but mostly it's just a great story about how, as a developer, you go through a bunch of difficult times trying to keep everyone happy, and how it's often the case that some people will be liking one thing and others will like something else, and you have to try your best to find a happy medium. Finally, number 5. If you are really hardcore for your game theory, it's math for game programmers, juicing your cameras with math. But don't click away just yet. It's not as scary as the word math usually is. In this video, so the description says the presenter's name is Squirrel Isolo. And I like that so much, I'm not even going to look up if it's correct. Anyway, Squirrel discusses different types of screen shake and camera movement and what the benefits of each is. He also covers really quickly at the end the idea of a Voronoi split screen, which is a smooth way to transition in and out of split screen for games that have multiple players on the screen. If you are technically minded, it's a great talk. And he gives you pseudocode math so you have a starting point for your implementation. And that's all I've got for you. Go and check out some of the great talks. Make sure to subscribe, and if you like game design, go check out some of the rest of my content. Thanks for watching.